Amid the chaos in Egypt, foreign journalists have become a target in what the U.S. State Department called a, quote, campaign to intimidate. Several dozen members of the press were rounded up by security forces and detained for hours yesterday. Across the city, angry mobs of Mubarak loyalists also reportedly beat journalists, with several reporters saying they were threatened with death. During a press gaggle on Air Force One, Press Secretary Robert Gibbs used some of his toughest language yet, saying the heavy-handed crackdown was, quote, completely and totally unacceptable. The State Department's P.J. Crowley says the United States has traced the attack to, quote, elements close to the government or the ruling party, unquote. But he stopped short of blaming the attack specifically on President Mubarak.
There are very strong indications that this is part of a concerted effort. I can't tell you who is directing it, but with the increasing number of instances of people roughed up, journalists' cars attacked, offices broken into, journalists detained, these do not seem to be random events.
Secretary of State Hillary Clinton also condemned the violence.
We condemn in the strongest terms attacks on reporters covering the ongoing situation in Egypt. This is a violation of international norms that guarantee freedom of the press, and it is unacceptable under any circumstances. We also condemn in the strongest terms attacks on peaceful demonstrators, human rights activists, foreigners, and diplomats. I urge the government and a broad and credible representation of Egypt's opposition, civil society, and political factions to begin immediately serious negotiations on a peaceful and orderly transition. The Egyptian people expect a meaningful process that yields concrete changes.
And earlier in the day at the National Prayer Breakfast in Washington, President Obama made his first public statement since Monday evening on Egypt.
And we pray that the violence in Egypt will end and that the rights and aspirations of the Egyptian people will be realized and that a better day will dawn over Egypt and throughout the world.
The president is expected to take questions from reporters later today for the first time since the crisis began.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
TeamHillaryClinton.com.